so good at it. She was the fattest girl in the first grade.
And you read that.
Quiet!
Chunko, chubbo, barf, but jelly roll, jelly roll.
And I have a few visitors in your dorm, they were in groups, and some of them stayed on the street.
I wanted to, but my dad had other plans. Like making me take over his work. I didn't mind. Why'd you?
You minded. I remember, thank you.
You're welcome.
You minded.
That was a long time ago. It's Scott's turn now. And I want him to pick a college. I want him to apply to college. He's got to pick a college. And so he can get into the one he wants.
But Scott wants Brooke Benedict.
Shut up, you little rug rat.
You watch your language.
Wait, she has another line.
Oh, I think he's close.
Okay, you shut up, you little rug rat.
Do I think that we're somewhat sensitive on a particular subject?
You watch your language. What's your dad listen? And you stop talking to someone on the DVC camera.
Great. Can you look at each person as you talk to them, please?
You watch your language. You stop talking to someone on the BBC.
Thank you. So
Jamie?
Have some rubbish, Dad. We can use the rubbish.
Rubbish? Go get him. What is this? San Francisco?
Of course, if Scott ever got Rick Benedict, he probably would know to do with her philosophically speaking.
Philosophically speaking, how do you know about her anyway?
I saw her name written all over your notebook. Only I found that pink of a girl in your room. I just must be her. She.
You were in my room?
Lying like a steel trap.
She was in my room. She was in my room.
Is this girl a friend of yours from Scott's? From school, Scott?
From Scott's?
She was in my room.
Yeah, cool.
If I have my own personal computer, I can bet my intellectual curiosity on that. Instead of sneaking in other people's rooms and degrading myself by talking to their personal possessions.
She was in my room.
Yes! Sit down! You dare you go to the room, I'll tell you intellectual curiosity.
Wait. Say that last thing again.
You stand in your brother's room and pretend your intellectual curiosity.
We always reduce it to the simplistic level of attack.
I'm gonna be a white beater.
When I was going through the parents' drawers the other day, saw Sumi on a shoe. I found pictures of them when they were young. She had on love me, a fringe vest. Wait, is that right?
A leather vest.
A leather vest and a fringe skirt. She looked like some kind of crazy urban Indian. The father had long hair and pink bell bottoms and a headband that said, "Make love, not war." Can you imagine what would happen if I said that at the dinner table some night? Please pass the beef, then, by the way, make love, not war. Total pink bell sound. Parents must have been really outraged before their arteries hardened. Now the highlight of their lives is going to the PTA carnival. Just goes to show what having kids will do to you.
Why don't you invite this girl over someday, Scott?
Mom, she barely knows I'm alive.
That's because you...
Travis! I have a script. Hey, Graham, you gotta do it.
30 seconds.
never asked for anything in my life. Calvin, they'll crash it to lunch money.
That, my man, is your problem. The way you run around these halls is a dead giveaway.
I'm kind of good to it.
Good to it.
He's nice.
Nice? I bet he's an animal.
Excuse me?
be?
Lily, I like you. You're smart, but you're not know it all. So here's some free advice. Relax a little, have some fun. If you like Carl, go for it.
I don't know how.
Sure you do. All you need is working getting started. You'd be surprised how much you get after a few beers.
Oh boy.
I want to adjust the camera.
Oh, it's yeah. When we get right down to it, you don't.
Rolling. Take four.
Party with my friends, right around in my car, using me to be a little bit popular, and not give me anything back. You are dead wrong.
You're out of line.
Oh yeah. But
you tried to help me and now you're in trouble.
Shh. Well, I always been dumb. It's one of my nicer qualities. Just ask Mom. Attention.
Gosh, my God.
Attention.
Attention.
Okay.
Okay.
Do you have something
to
do for your
group?
It's still rolling, stupid.
It's still rolling, stupid.
Go ahead, Mom.
Welcome to detention. Welcome to
detention, or as we like to
call it,
run all the way from home.
Speak up.
Ben and Hope, all you who enter here, bud.
You know those girls on the cover of 17? Perfect hair, perfect chin, perfect clothes, perfect bodies. Perfect. And they make you look so easy.
What part are you on the line?
And they make it look so easy. But it's not. Always wearing the right thing, always saying the right thing, always doing things right. You can't be too quiet, then you're a nerd. You can't be too loud, then you're a geek. You can't drag home too many books, then you're a grind. But if you fail, then you're a burnout.
Shut up!
There's so much to remember, it makes my head ache.
That's right.
But it's worth it. Everybody knows me now. I party with the cool kids, sit with the cool kids, walk and talk and act just like one of them. And if I'm not one of them, then everybody thinks I am, and that's the important thing. Even my mom. I hear her on the phone now, bragging to her friends. Omar, so
Omar, they're found
a stop it. Omar, the way Brooke goes out these days. The phone is always ringing. She's always out somewhere. She's one popular girl, just like I was. But I'm not just like she was. It was easy for her. Or maybe it wasn't. Sometimes I wish my mom knew about the hair and the clothes and the makeup so I could talk to her. Sometimes I don't think she'd care if she did know, because she'd think it was worth it too. Because it is. It's gotta be. I sit at the right lunch table with the right kids, and I see people walk by and look at us and pretend not to look, and I know just what they're thinking. Why can't I do that? Be like that? Why can't I bring it off? It looks so easy. But it's not. Changing yourself, turning yourself inside out and upside down, trying to please a zillion people and make them like you? Hard. 17 lives. It's not easy at all.
I told her she can't do it. I told her it doesn't matter who you hang out with or how you talk or look. You can't change what's inside.
Okay.
People don't care what's inside. Inside doesn't matter.
Inside's all that matters.
And
the way I look at it, everything I've got is going to either drop, drip, drag, wrinkle up, or go away. I got work on the inside.
Guys,
we're ready for the end of the scene. Start your chant.
We're gross.
Boxing.
Maybe time. Definitely time. I could be person of the year. Person of the next couple of years.
My name's my right. Time. Fortune. Cinnamon's
quarter.
GQ.
Matt.
Yeah?
Rolling Stone.
Wait a minute.
No,
just like 40 years.
Because Howie says mad, Len says mad, Burnham says mad, and all three say mad.
Everybody else says mad.
Yeah, two gentlemen's
is too weird, man.
I've got it all. I mean, I really do have it all. Nice car, great house, plenty of bucks, and more where that came from. Not that the old man was always loaded. I've seen pictures of when I was young. The three-bedroom cracker box and the ticky-tacky suburb. All the streets are named like Elm or Maple or Shady Lane.
Shady Lane?
Not a tree for miles, and all the streets are named Elm or Maple or Shady Lane. Man, it's weird to look at those pictures. The old lady doesn't have her year-round tan. The old man doesn't have his briefcase. And the pictures of them together, those are the weirdest of all. Of course, I understand all about why the old man split. He explained it to me. My dad and I never talk much. When you're raking in the bucks, you don't want some stupid, snotty kid hanging on you. But, I mean, we talked, father and son stuff. You know, how about them hawks, or how about them giants, or Knicks, or Jays, or Bulls, or Bears, or Reds, or Blues, or Jets, or Mets? Jeez. And when I got a little overheated with that one chick, you know, he told me to cool it, because it can cost a guy a bundle if he gets a broad knocked up. But when he left, we had a real man-to-man. He said he found this girl, that she made him feel young. I can understand that. Everyone wants to be young, right? Mom tries to be young. She's always playing tennis or at our aerobics class, always getting her legs waxed or her tummy tucked or her saddlebag suctioned, always getting her hair tinted or dyed or permed or peeled or painted. Or her face tightened or peeled or painted. I think she had a facelift once. She didn't say anything, but she left for about a week, and when she came back, she went everywhere with these dark glasses on. I caught her one time looking in the mirror, saying things like, "That'll get him." She knows a lot of people. At her dumb wife's support group. At her aerobics class, at her dumb wife's support group. That's not what she calls her, of course, but that's what it is. And then there's all her best friends. Little white ones, little pink ones, little blue ones. Yeah, she's got a whole medicine cabinet full of friends. I came home real late one night, and she was singing and dancing, real up, real happy. I thought, Dad's coming back. But she just met her first friend. She explained it all to me. She said, a woman can't drink. It's bad if you drink and ruin your skin. Pills just make the pain go away. And she was right. And she was right. They're the best friends of all. Better than friends, better than parents. They're always there when you need them, and they never let you down.
Looking at you while you're the girl of his dreams.
he hadn't been defending what he thought was your butt, you would have been.
Push pause.
suggested.
Oh, the gross.
Oh, that's gross.
It'll be depressing.
I'll look desperate.
I am desperate. What if he doesn't show?
This could be my lucky night.
Yeah.
Here, a little bit more this way. Thanks.